Okay, good morning or good afternoon. We are having a conversation with Mr. Pierre Grigor today from EduVisa, and we are very excited to talk about the new program we're going to implement at the International Rugby Institute. Within the next few years, hopefully we'll give all the players and everybody else another exit that we're going to put out there. Doesn't matter if you if you're a professional rugby player or not, you can study. So Pierre, welcome, and thank you for being here. We all of us are excited because rugby players usually nowadays everybody's looking for another exit after their rugby career. So so tell us a bit more about EduVisa, and then obviously your part in it.
EduVisa is a private university accredited on Ofqual accredited system in the UK. So it's accredited course. It facilitates a few qualifications. Maybe just start up with the fact that a lot of people, 70% of South African students don't get admitted to the universities in Africa. So there's a lot of people trying to study out there, but they haven't got the opportunity to do that. With EduVisa, you don't have to have a matric, because a lot of people only start studying or getting into the study thing mode after matric.
Yeah,
they don't want to study, but so we say we've got the we give them the opportunity to do a sort of a bridging course where you have to you get used to the British system.
Yeah.
You do a diploma. It's a diploma in higher education access. You can do it in 3 months, but you get a year to complete that.
Yeah.
So if you pass that, you are automatically admitted to the first diploma. It's a diploma in management, which is also your first year of your BBA degree. That's a bachelor's in business administration.
Okay.
You get a year to complete that, but you can do it in a shorter time, obviously, yeah, because you're not on a campus and there's a lot of time that you're wasting there. But with this, you can do it in your time. So most of the students do it in 6 months.
Yeah.
The second diploma, so that's actually the second diploma, but this is the first diploma of your BBA degree. Your second diploma is your higher diploma in management. Mm. Which is your, so actually that's your third diploma, which you the third diploma, which is your second year of your BBA degree.
Yes.
Also get 6 months, a year to do that, but you can do it in 6 months
time. Yeah.
And which is nice for the students. They play rugby and they can use their time
fruitfully. Yeah.
Very fruitfully. Yeah. And then your fourth diploma is your graduate diploma, which is your third year of your BBA degree on the British Ofqual system, qualifications board system. You can also you get a year to complete that, but it's most of the students, as I said, do it in a year's time. So after if you do it in 6 years time, 6 months time. You do it in a year and a half. You can do four qualifications in a year and a half.
Sure, that's impressive.
And then after your fourth diploma, your graduate diploma, you do a top up, do a few models, and then you can be admitted to the BBA degree. So with that, can take you about 3 months time. And then you do it online with a British university, and that's where why we call it EduVisa. It's a sort of a visa.
Yeah.
You're admitted to the British
system,
academic system.
Yeah.
And then but most of the students don't do the BBA degree because there's another path.
you instead of doing the BBA degree, which is this one is expensive because you do it directly with a university, British university, they rather go for the other option, which is a postgraduate diploma in management.
Okay.
So it's actually your fifth diploma that you're doing. Which is also a year, but most of the students do it in 6 months' time. And then after that, you do a few modules, and then you're admitted to the MBA Masters of Business Administration. You also do that directly with a British university. That's a bit more expensive. The first diploma, which is the diploma in higher education access, which is your bridging diploma, which takes you about 3 months. That is 4,900 rand.
That's extremely cheap.
Your second diploma, your third diploma, and your fourth diploma are all 14,950 rand. That's about more than half than equal other universities that also have that on their university menu.
Yeah.
So it's very, very cheap. Mm. When you do the BBA or the MBA, it's a bit more expensive. It's around about 50,000 rand.
Yeah.
And upwards, which is more expensive.
But the amount of money that you save over the years,
yeah,
you can. That's still a bargain because it's still cheaper than anything else out there.
Absolutely, it's not. You won't find that in South Africa. Mm. So the nice thing is you can do your sport, and you can enroll with a university, and you can do it on your time.
Yeah,
which is the nice thing is you don't have to have matric. So
that was the thing that we spoke about, which is for us, that's the thing that makes us so excited is because not everybody gets exemption
or gets admitted to university. Yeah.
But when it comes back to the even guys that's not making a trick and they think it's the end of the world, this is the option.
This is beautiful. So you can get qualifications. On the British system, which is higher academic value, and you don't even have to have matric. In my case, I wasn't a good student at school. I only discovered the studies after school. Mm-hmm. So and then I only started studying and learning how to study after school. So for a person like me, that would have been and beautiful option for me to start studying, not even having matric exemption, you know. So you don't have to have in a South African situation. You have to have what's it? Grade 9, standard 7, grade 9. Grade 9. Yeah. So that's compulsory. After that, you don't have to have a matric in South Africa.
Yes.
So technically, person can start after grade 7.
Yeah, when he's 16. Grade 9. When he's 16 years old.
Yeah, when he's 16 years old.
16 years old, he can actually start focusing in a direction.
You can start.
And I think we spoke about it yesterday, and is that the fact that there's nothing wrong with our education system because we deliver people that doctors, engineers, whatever it is out
beautiful
there.
Beautiful students, yeah.
But still, people, it takes too long for a person to start going in his direction.
Yeah, that's another thing you're touching now on, Marinus, is you can start any time of the year.
Yes.
So you don't have to start January or June.
Oh, yes.
So you can start
There's no semester.
You do it on your time, and you can finish it as soon as you finish your degree. You can go on to your diploma. You can go on to the next one. And as I said, it's accredited with the British system.
Okay. Now, a diploma. Just explain what is a diploma, because in South Africa we've got this certain standards, and it's usually a certificate, and then you go to a diploma. And it's I know that all the NQF levels that's involved in it, but the British system is different than that, which is great for anybody out there.
Yeah, you can do a diploma in 1 year. In South Africa, I think you can also start. In our time, a certificate was three months or something sometimes to a year, and the diploma was 2 years. Now it's changed. The academic world changed. It adapted to the circumstances. So
you can do a diploma
in 1 year, 1 year's time now, as long as you complete fulfill the academic requirements.
Yeah.
There must be a minimum academic requirement for your study. So, which is beautiful with the bridging diploma, they teach you how to do research, because not everyone, when you're done with school, you don't know how to do research.
Yes.
They teach you some of the modules. One of the modules is how to do research, how to write a dissertation. It's very important. Even at university, they don't really teach you that. They've got that modules, those modules, only when you do an honors or master's degree.
Yes, yes.
They teach you how to, some instances, only when you do a doctorate, they teach you how, you've got a module where you start doing, teaching you how to do research and do the reference system and that stuff. With the bridging diploma, that you start off with that. So
yeah,
you sort of
fantastic.
Get the tools, as you start studying, you get the tools so you can complete it.
Okay. Now, one more question, one or two more questions. Everybody's scared to study online because they're scared they might not. First thing is to register. That's the first thing. And through us and our working relationship, it's going to be easy for us to do that. But people are sometimes scared to do it.
Yeah.
And this system is easy, simple.
It's very easy. Yeah. It takes you by the hand. Everything is on the computer. You can download it. You can have the manual, the physical manual in your hand. You can do it online, and they guide you through the process. So it's very, very easy to start doing it. And maybe the different directions that...
Yes, we spoke about what we can specialize in the future. For example, it's all management, business management, but I mean, so not everybody is going in the same direction when it, regarding that. Can you just maybe
You start off with a sort of a generic, in Britain you've got, you can start specializing from the beginning, from your first year, but not in the South African system. We've got this generic course. That's why in your first year you do a lot of subjects. In your second year you do two or three subjects. You start specializing more, and your third year you sort of specialize where you got your two subjects in your honors, and then you specialize eventually, but not initially. With the British system, you can start specializing in the beginning, but with any visa, have this relationship where they started off with a generic first year where you touch on everything, so it'll give you a nice foundation on everything, and from your second year you can specialize in IT or in human resources or leadership or management, and it's about hospitality. There's about 8 different sort of focus points where you can specialize in. And that's normally from your higher diploma, your first diploma, your management diploma is the nice generic one. From your second diploma, you start specializing.
Yeah, because I see stuff like business management, entrepreneurship, hotel and hospitality, HR management, leadership and teamwork, sales and marketing, accounting and finances, IT and computing. So it's a vast array of
and the interesting thing about the British system is you can do an MBA in airport management. You know, they can, you can specialize sort of in a very narrow direction, because the world out in the first world countries are just different than our African situation.
Yes,
you can indeed. You've got this major airports where you can only focus on airport management. You
know, so it's very specialized.
Your master, your MBA degrees can be very specialized and very focused on a very, very small focus point, but not in South Africa, because we haven't got that jack of all trades. So we do everything.
And then one last thing is that obviously we're gonna have a campus here. It'll be a campus where the boys will have access to computers and everything else. And then they can come in and make use of those facilities to make sure that they have access to the internet and everything else, which makes it very simple and easy. And they are rugby players. In the beginning, they are rugby players and then students.
Yeah.
But we will eventually, hopefully, turn it around as they become older and more in our system. And as they go along, they will be student rugby players.
Yeah, I think the parents will be more satisfied knowing that the child is studying and sort of preparing for the world out for. Just another thing, which it's a nice thing as well, Marinus, is Eddie Visa's got this relationship with Mobi Credit. It's a credit system that they are running.
Yes, we spoke about that.
Yeah, where the parents can apply for credit online, so they can pay off their studies on a monthly. They get, I think they give you 12 months to pay back your income, and so it's a it's a nice system to have, because it's although 5,000 and 14,900 it's not a lot of money, especially when you stretch it over years time, but if you have to pay it in one or two amounts, so it can be difficult for some parents.
That's great for most people. Like our program, everybody has got a monthly installment, and that makes it just a little bit easier to have that monthly installment.
Absolutely.
And the price point, I think that's the main thing, is the price point. And everywhere we go, and with all the partners that we had in the past, it was just too expensive, because obviously the guys are here full time every day, rugby, and it's a lot of effort that we put in. But when you add that on top of the rugby, the amount of money they've got to pay you and the fee that they have to pay you, it just gets too expensive. The parents say, no, leave do the rugby for 1 year and leave the academic side of it. And we want them to have a bit of a balance, otherwise they lay in their rooms and play PlayStation, or sleep the whole day.
Yeah. So now you can use your time more productively.
Exactly. So, thank you. Thanks, Pierre. I'm looking forward, and the management are looking forward to walking this journey with you guys. We spoke about the UK only, but I mean, there's countries like Singapore and Australia and universities in Australia that
access to those
universities. Yeah. So our boys can hopefully, get access. Play rugby in a different country and keep on studying.
Absolutely,
and that's what we're about.
We're looking forward to having this relationship, Marinus. Mm.
Thank you very much. Really appreciate it.
Thank you very much.
Okay, guys, that's it. If you've got any questions, it'll be on our website. There'll also be a link on this video as well, and then we'll take you through the steps to make sure that everybody understands what we want to achieve with the rugby program, but also with the academic program.